Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I was inspired by the wedding season. So today's hairstyles kind of have a boho wedding vibe, I think. But of course you can wear these whenever or wherever you want to. So I hope you enjoyed today's video. Make sure to like and subscribe and click the notification bell so you never miss a future video. And let's get started. The first hairstyle is going to be a half up style with two fringe braids and a little mini bun. So for this hairstyle, I'm going to have my hair parted on the right side. I just prefer this side for my hairstyles. So then I'm going to continue the part a little ways down the back of my head, just about halfway down, and I'm doing a zigzag part so there's not a definite line between the two braids. And then I'm just going to clip away the hair on the right side since I'm going to start with the hair on the left side. So I'm dividing out some pieces to frame my face, and then I'm just going to pick up a section for the braid. And I'm dividing this section into three pieces, and since I'm doing a French braid, I'm going to be crossing the side strands over the middle strand. So after the first stitch of the braid, I'm going to begin picking up new sections of hair from along the part on the top side of the braid and from along the hairline on the bottom side of the braid, and then incorporate these pieces into the braid. I'm only going to bring in about three sections, and they're fairly large sections because I want the style to feel very loose and flowy. And when you bring in smaller sections, it can make the style seem a little bit too tight and more rigid. So once I've brought in my three sections on both sides of the braid, I'm just going to braid the hair a little further down in a regular three strand braid, again crossing the side strands over the middle strand, and then I'm going to slide a bobby pin over the end of the braid so that it doesn't unravel. Now I'm going to add another French braid on the right side of my head in the same way that I did the left side. Since my part is on the side, I have a little less hair on this side of my head, so I'm only going to incorporate one section from above my ear, so I still have a fair amount of hair on this side of my head hanging down from the braid, but I'm going to add in about four sections from along the top side of my head. I want the two braids to meet together at the back of my head, but I don't want to have a big gap at the back, so I'm just going to keep adding in sections until the two braids touch at the back. You can always add in more or less sections depending on how you want your version to look. But once the two braids meet at the back of my head, I'm just going to braid the section a little further down and then slide another bobby pin over the bottom. So once both braids are done, I'm going to do the little bun, but I don't want to use all of the hair from the braids. So I'm going to remove the bobby pins from the ends of the braids, and then what I'm going to do is take one section of hair from the outside of both braids and combine these together. I'm going to tie them off with a clear elastic band, and on the last wrap of the elastic, I'm only going to pull the hair partway through to create a little loop, and then I'm just going to take the ends and wrap them twice around the elastic, and then just tuck the ends into the elastic band underneath the bun, and that will hold them in place. The second hairstyle is a ponytail style with two Dutch fishtail braids. So I'm going to start by parting my hair on the right side, and then I'm going to add a headband to dress up the style, and I'm just placing this about an inch or two back from the hairline. And I'm going to divide out some hair to frame my face and then just pick up a section of hair for the braid. I want the braid to come straight down from the headband, so I'm picking up a piece on the left side of the headband and a second piece from the right side of the headband. And to do the Dutch fishtail braid, I'm going to start with a Dutch braid, just one stitch. So I'm going to split the section on the right side into two pieces. So I'm going to cross the very far right section underneath to the left, and then the left side section underneath to the right, and combine those two right pieces together. And then I'm going to do the Dutch fishtail braid. So I'm taking a small section from the right side, crossing it underneath to the left, and then I'm going to pick up a section, cross it under, and add it into the left side as well. And then I'm going to cross a small piece from the left side under to the right, pick up a new section of hair and cross it under to the right side as well. This will just make it so that there's not a gap at the top of the braid. And I'm just going to continue this pattern, taking small pieces of hair from one side, crossing them underneath the braid, and then adding them into the opposite side, while also picking up new sections of hair from underneath the braid and adding them into the opposite side as well. And this is the technique to creating a Dutch fishtail braid. So I'm just going to continue the braid, working my way along the side of my head. And once I brought in hair from above my ear, I'm going to stop bringing in hair along this side of the braid so I don't get any bumps in the hair when I pull the braid into the ponytail. But I am going to continue adding in pieces to the top side of the braid from along the back of my head. I don't want to have any gaps in the hair when I bring the two braids together. And then so the braid doesn't unravel, I'm just going to slide a bobby pin over the bottom. Now I'm going to repeat those previous steps and create a second Dutch fishtail braid on the right side. It's the same process, so I'm just taking two pieces from both sides of the headband and beginning the braid, crossing small sections of hair from one side underneath, adding them into the opposite side. So I'm just taking a small piece from one side, crossing it under and adding it to the other side, picking up a new section of hair, crossing it underneath and adding it to the opposite side as well. And I'm just going to incorporate hair into the braid from along the top of my head and from along the hairline as I did before. And once I brought in hair from above my ear, I'm going to stop bringing in hair along this side of the braid, but continue adding in pieces to the top side of the braid just to ensure there are no gaps in the hair when the two braids meet together at the back. And then so the braid doesn't unravel, I'm just going to slide a bobby pin over the bottom. Once both braids are done, I'm going to combine all of my hair together along with the braids and tie it into a ponytail using a hairband. And then I'm just going to hide the hairband. So I'm taking a small piece of hair from the ponytail, wrapping it around the band, and then bobby pin the hair underneath the ponytail so that it doesn't come loose. The third style is a crown braid. So for this hairstyle, I'm going to part my hair into two sections. So I'm creating a zigzag part line down the back of my head. Doing this will help hide the actual part line instead of just doing a straight line. So then I'm just going to clip away the hair on the right side to start with the hair on the left. And I'm going to leave out some hair to frame my face, as usual. Pick up a piece to begin my braid, and I'm splitting this into three sections. And since I'm doing a Dutch braid, I'm going to be crossing the side strands under the middle strand. So as I braid, I'm also incorporating new sections of hair into the braid, and I want to add in all of the hair from the left side of my head. So I'm just trailing the braid around the left side, incorporating new pieces as I go, and I'm bringing them into both sides of the braid. And then once the braid reaches the back of my head and I've brought in all of the hair from this side, I'm just going to continue braiding this section all the way down to the ends and then slide a bobby pin over the bottom. Now I'm going to let down the hair on the right side and repeat the same steps, creating another Dutch braid. So I'm leaving out some hair to frame my face again, and I'm going to pick up a section near the part and divide it into three pieces. Again, I'm crossing the side strands under the middle strand, and I'm going to be incorporating new sections into the braid on both sides. This braid is going to sit above the other braid, so I want to make sure to keep it a little bit higher on my head so they can easily overlap once I pin them. So after all of the hair from this right side is brought into the braid, I'm just going to continue braiding the section down to the ends, and then again slide a bobby pin over the bottom so it doesn't unravel. And now I'm going to take both braids and wrap them around to the front of my head, and I'm going to kind of pinch and pull on different pieces of the braid just so it's soft and I like the way they come together. And then I'm just going to use the bobby pins from the ends of the braids to pin the hair in place. I didn't want to braid the hair all the way to the bottom just because the braids get so skinny and small. So I actually just kind of twist the hair, and you just want to make sure to hide the bobby pins as best you can just so that they don't show. I like to slide them into the hair but then under the braid, and then that really helps hide them. That wraps up today's tutorial. Let me know in the comment section which of the three hairstyles was your favorite. I think if I was going to be a guest at a wedding anytime soon, I would probably do the half of braids, but let me know which one is your favorite. Make sure to like and subscribe in case you haven't already, and click that notification bell so you never miss a future video, and I will see you next time.